Celebrate a very great day. This day is the best day in existence. It is the most beloved day to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named it Yawm al-Nahr, the day of sacrifice, as he stated alayhi salatu wa salam, Inna a'zama al-ayyami 'inda Allah Yawm al-Nahr. Indeed, the greatest day in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the day of sacrifice. In this day, we remember the ultimate sacrifice, the ultimate test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam with. We show our servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by sacrificing our udhiyah as a proof of our iman and our submission to Allah, the most merciful, Ar-Rahman. Today, we celebrate the blessings, the rewards, the bounties, the forgiveness, the safety that is given within these 10 days. From the greatest blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this nation with, from the greatest blessings that we should celebrate, is the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen the greatest man to be the leader, to be the carrier of the flag of Iman, to be the prophet of our nation, the nation of Islam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, it is the greatest honor to be a believer amongst the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final messenger and the best of mankind. Nowadays, there is a vicious attack directed at our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, trying to demolish the image of the best of mankind. It is a duty upon you and me, my brothers in Islam. It is a duty upon each and every Muslim to defend the honor of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with everything we have, with our blood, with our sweat, with our tears. We should be able and willing to put everything on the line to defend Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By Allah, we will never reach the true level of Iman until we put everything we can on the line to defend the Messenger of Islam. The first and the most important action you can take in defending the Messenger of Islam is by knowing and spreading his virtues and his seerah, Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. So who is Muhammad? Who is the Messenger of Islam? Allah Azza wa Jal looked into the hearts of mankind and he found the best and the purest to be the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he chose him to be the Prophet of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be the final messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to save a lost nation that was on the verge of doom and destruction. Yes, my brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for you and me, for our children to have a chance at entering Jannah and to be saved from the Niran. Who is he? Who is Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam? He was the greatest man that Allah has ever created. He was the wisest in his leadership. He was the fairest in his judgment. He was the most caring in his parenthood, alayhi salatu wassalam. He was the best husband, the best father, the best teacher, Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. He was the supreme leader, yet he was the most humble in his character, alayhi salatu wassalam. He was the most devoted man to ever worship the most merciful, Ar-Rahman. He prayed alayhi salatu wassalam until his feet would swell. His wife Aisha would ask him, O Prophet of Allah, how come you put so much effort to pray and praise Allah while Allah has forgiven all your past, all your future sins? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, shall I not be a
a grateful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be the leader of mankind on the day of judgment. He will be the first to be resurrected, the first to intercede, the first to cross the sirat, the first to enter Jannah, the first alayhi salatu wa salam. From the greatest virtues of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are his manners and character. And that is manifested through the sacrifices he placed on the line for the sake of Islam. When he first called to Islam, his family, his tribe, and his enemy all opposed him, and an aggressive war was waged against him. He was starved, he was tortured, he was attacked, he was imprisoned, and he was humiliated, all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he would not even budge alayhi salatu wasalam. He faced it all until he stated alayhi salatu wasalam in a hadith, which means, I have been tortured for the sake of Allah as no one else has, and I have suffered fear for the sake of Allah azza wa jal as no one else has. I have spent 3 days when Bilal and I had no food that any living being could eat, but that which could be concealed under the armpits of Bilal. He was patient for no reason other than calling humanity to return to their Lord, calling them to be saved from the blazing fire and to inherit the eternal abode. He stood firm in the face of poverty, hunger, oppression, and he gave it all he can. In the midst of all these struggles, his enemies, they presented him with dunya, all the money he could ever have, the woman, leadership, status, all.
We gather here today to celebrate a very great day. This day is the best day in existence. It is the most beloved day to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam named it Yawm al-Nahr, the day of sacrifice, as he stated alayhi salatu wa salam, Inna a'zama al-ayyami inda Allahi Yawm al-Nahr. Indeed, the greatest day in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the day of sacrifice. In this day, we remember the ultimate sacrifice, the ultimate test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam.